everybody, and welcome to our service of morning prayer for today, Friday the 7th of October. Let's just turn our hearts to the Lord as we rejoice to be in his presence. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Blessed are you, sovereign God, creator of all. To you be glory and praise forever. You founded the earth in the beginning, and the heavens are the work of your hands. In the fullness of time, you made us in your image. And in these last days, you have spoken to us in your Son, Jesus Christ, the Word made flesh. As we rejoice in the gift of your presence among us, let the light of your love always shine in our hearts, your Spirit ever renew our lives, and your praises ever be on our lips. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God forever. The night has passed and the day lies open before us. Let us pray with one heart and mind. As we rejoice in the gift of this new day, so may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and forever. Amen. Today's psalm is Psalm number 51, and we begin by saying the refrain together. The sacrifice of God is a broken spirit. Have mercy on me, O God, in your great goodness. According to the abundance of your compassion, blot out my offences. Wash me thoroughly from my wickedness and cleanse me from my sin. For I acknowledge my faults and my sin is ever before me. Against you only have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight, so that you are justified in your sentence and righteous in your judgment. I have been wicked even from my birth, a sinner when my mother conceived me. Behold, you desire truth deep within me, and shall make me understand wisdom in the depths of my heart. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Make me hear of joy and gladness, that the bones you have broken may rejoice. Turn your face from my sins and blot out all my misdeeds. Make me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Give me again the joy of your salvation, and sustain me with your gracious spirit. Then shall I teach your ways to the wicked, and sinners shall return to you. Deliver me from my guilt, O God, the God of my salvation, and my tongue shall sing of your righteousness. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall proclaim your praise. For you desire no sacrifice, else I would give it. You take no delight in burnt offerings. The sacrifice of God is a broken spirit, a broken and contrite heart, O God, you will not despise. O be favourable and gracious to Zion. Build up the walls of Jerusalem. Then you will accept sacrifices offered in righteousness, the burnt offerings and oblations. Then shall they offer bulls on your altar. The sacrifice of God is a broken spirit. Take away, good Lord, the sin that corrupts us. Give us the sorrow that heals and the joy that praises, and restore by grace your own image within us, that we may take our place among your people. In Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. And now it's over to Joslyn for our two readings.
Our Old Testament reading is taken from 1 Kings, chapter 18, verses 21 to the end. Elijah then came near to all the people and said, "How long will you go limping with two different opinions? If the Lord is God, follow him. But if Baal, then follow him." The people did not answer him a word. Then Elijah said to the people, I only am left a prophet of the Lord, but Baal's prophets number 450. Let two bulls be given to us. Let them choose one bull for themselves, cut it in pieces and lay it on the wood, but put no fire on it. I will prepare the other bull and lay it on the wood, but put no fire to it. Then you call on the name of your God, and I will call on the name of the Lord. The God who answers by fire is indeed God. All the people answered, "Well spoken." Then Elijah said to the prophets of Baal, "Choose for yourselves one bull and prepare it first, for you are many. Then call on the name of your God, but put no fire to it." So they took the bull that was given them, prepared it, and called on the name of Baal from morning until noon, crying, "O Baal, answer us." But there was no voice and no answer. They limped about the altar that they'd made. At noon, Elijah mocked them, saying, "Cry aloud, surely he's a god. Either he's meditating, or he was wandering away, or he's on a journey, or perhaps he's asleep. I must be wakened." Then they cried aloud, and as was their custom, they cut themselves with swords and lances until the blood gushed out over them. As midday passed, they raved on until the time of the offering of the oblation, but there was no voice, no answer, and no response. Then Elijah said to all the people, "Come closer to me." And all the people came closer to him. First, he repaired the altar of the Lord that had been thrown down. Elijah took 12 stones, according to the number of the tribes of the sons of Jacob, to whom the word of the Lord came, saying, "Israel shall be your name." With the stones, he built an altar in the name of the Lord. Then he made a trench around the altar, large enough to contain 2 measures of seed. Next, he put the wood in order, cut the bull in pieces and laid it on the wood. He said, "Fill 4 jars with water and pour it on the burnt offering and on the wood." Then he said, "Do it a second time." And they did it a second time. Again, he said, "Do it a third time." And they did it a third time. So the water ran all around the altar and filled the trench also with water. At the time of the offering of the oblation, the prophet Elijah came near and said, "O Lord, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, let it be known this day that you are God in Israel, that I am your servant, and that I have done all these things at your bidding. Answer me, O Lord, answer me, so that this people may know that you, O Lord, are God, and that you have turned their hearts back." Then the fire of the Lord fell and consumed the burnt offering, the wood, the stones, and the dust, and even licked up the water that was in the trench. When all the people saw it, they fell on their faces and said, "The Lord indeed is God. The Lord indeed is God." Elijah said to them, "Seize the prophets of Baal. Do not let one of them escape." Then they seized them, and Elijah brought them down to the Wadi Kishon and killed them there. Elijah said to Ahab, "Go up and eat and drink, for there is a sound of rushing rain." So Ahab went up to eat and to drink. Elijah went up to the top of Carmel. There he bowed himself down upon the earth and put his face between his knees. He said to his servant, "Go up now, look towards the sea." He went up and looked and said, "There is nothing." Then he said, go again seven times. At the seventh time, he said, look, a little cloud no bigger than a person's hand is rising out of the sea. Then he said, go and say to Ahab, harness your chariot and go down before the rain stops you. In a little while, the heavens grew black with clouds and wind. There was a heavy rain. Ahab rode off and went to Jezreel. The hand of the Lord was on Elijah. He girded up his loins and ran in front of Ahab to the entrance of Jezreel. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. We now come to our New Testament reading, which is taken from the book of Acts, chapter 21, verses 1 to 16. When we parted from them and set sail, we came to a straight course to Kos, and the next day to Rhodes, and from there to Patara, when we found a ship called the Phoenicia. We went on board and set sail. We came in sight of Cyprus, and leaving it on our left, we sailed to Syria and landed at Tyre, because the ship was to unload its cargo there. We looked up the disciples and stayed there for 7 days. Through the Spirit, they told Paul not to go on to Jerusalem. When our days there were ended, we left and proceeded on our journey, and all of them, with wives and children, escorted us outside the city. There we knelt down on the beach and prayed and said farewell to one another. Then we went on board the ship and they returned home. When we had finished the voyage from Tyre, we arrived at Ptolemais and we greeted the believers and stayed with them one day. The next day we left and came to Caesarea, and we went into the house of Philip, the evangelist, one of the seven, and stayed with him. He had four unmarried daughters who had the gift of prophecy. While we were staying there for several days, a prophet named Agabus came down from Judea. He came to us and took Paul's belt, bound his own feet and hands with it, and said, thus says the Holy Spirit, this is the way the Jews in Jerusalem will bind the man who owns this belt and will hand him over to the Gentiles. When we heard this, we and the people there urged him not to go up to Jerusalem. Then Paul answered, what are you doing weeping and breaking my heart? For I'm ready not only to be bound, but even to die in Jerusalem for the name of the Lord Jesus. Since he would not be persuaded, we remained silent, except to say, the Lord's will be done. After these days, we got ready and started to go to Jerusalem. Some of the disciples from Caesarea also came along and brought us to the house of Nemesis of Cyprus, an early disciple with whom we were to stay. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Calvary, where Jesus bled and died for me. I see his wounds, his hands, his feet, my Savior on that cursed tree. The name of the Lord our God. shall pierce the night, and I will rise among the saints, my gaze transfixed on Jesus.
Sing that again.
Forsake me not, O Lord, be not far from me, O my God. Forsake me not, O Lord, be not far from me, O my God. Make haste to help me, O Lord of my salvation. Be not far from me, O my God. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Forsake me not, O Lord, be not far from me, O my God. And we say the Benedictus together, beginning with the refrain. Give your people knowledge of salvation, O God, by the forgiveness of all their sins. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, who has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Saviour, born of the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets, God promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our ancestors, and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath God swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life. And you, child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of all their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Give your people knowledge of salvation, O God, by the forgiveness of all their sins. And so we come to our time of intercession, when we can bring to the Lord whatever is on our hearts today. But bring them to the Lord, who is more ready to hear than we are to pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your presence with us as we spend this time worshipping you together. And we thank you for this day which lies before us and all the tasks that lie before us. Lord, may all that we do be done in the power of your Spirit and to the glory of your name. And may we always share your love with those we meet along the way. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we pray for the world and its needs, and we pray for the worldwide church. And Lord, we remember today that there are many people who are not free to worship openly as we do, but have to do so in secret, because there are those who would persecute them and harm them and even kill them to stop them worshipping you. We pray for those believers, Lord, and we pray that they may know your presence with them in all that they do. We pray for those who persecute you, Lord, that you would open their eyes to see the error of their ways, and to meet with you, the living God, who loves them as much as you love us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those parts of the world where people live in situations of desperate need and suffering, for those who struggle to make ends meet, for those who struggle to grow enough food to eat, or who cannot find a job, who cannot pay the rent because they have no work and they have no one to provide for them. Lord, we pray that you will provide for them in your grace and mercy, and may they know that you care for them. We pray for those who are suffering from drought, as they are in Northeast Africa. And we suffer for those who are living in situations of flood, as they are in Pakistan and Bangladesh, which often has terrible floods. And Lord, we also pray, as we're now in the hurricane season, we pray for those who are suffering from the effects of hurricanes. We think of Cuba, which was facing a hurricane a week or so ago. And we pray for other countries that are also affected by these dreadful natural calamities, Lord. And we pray that you will protect people, that they may be able to find a safe haven when that storm comes, and that they would get the help and support they need to clear up after the event. We pray for the aid agencies which work so hard, Lord, to help clearing up, rescuing people and helping them to rebuild for the future. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the King, particularly, Lord, as he has so recently ascended to the throne. We pray that he may know your presence with him and your wisdom in this new role that he has just recently taken on. And we pray for him as he prays and prepares for his coronation in the months ahead. Give him wisdom in all he does. May he truly be a channel of your love and your grace to all those he meets along the way. We pray for the rest of the royal family, for the Prince and Princess of Wales, for the Queen Consort, and for other members of the royal family who are no doubt still mourning the loss, the death of the Queen. We pray that they may all know your presence with them and your comfort in their sorrow. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the members of Parliament, and we particularly pray for the Prime Minister, Liz Truss, and for all members of her government. Lord, may they have special wisdom as they face such major problems, and it's very difficult to know what is the best way to support those who are struggling. Lord, they need your wisdom, and we pray, Lord, that you will guide them, that they will be open to your leading, and that they will have the courage, Lord, if they make mistakes, to acknowledge that and to do what they can to correct it. We pray, Lord, that in the days ahead, those people in our society who most need help and support will receive it, either through the government or through other agencies. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for peace and justice in the world, and we remember those countries where there is no peace and no justice. I'm sure we will all have different countries on our hearts at this time, but I want to pray for Ukraine, that ongoing conflict. Lord, we know that you're present in that situation, but somehow it just seems to get worse, and there seems to be no end in sight. So, Lord, we pray that you will work in that situation, that you will encourage President Zelensky and his colleagues in Ukraine and all those who are fighting to keep Ukraine free. And we pray for President Putin. Lord, we pray that you will also speak to him and work in his heart to change his attitudes and to bring him to a place and a way of seeking peace and not conflict. We pray for all those who have suffered because of this conflict or because of other conflicts, like the one in Yemen that's been going on for so long, and other conflicts, Lord, which are there but don't get mentioned in the news. We lift them all to you, Lord, and we pray for those who are working for peace and reconciliation. May they truly be channels of your peace, and may the Prince of Peace be free to work where there is such conflict, Lord, and bring peace and understanding between different groups of people. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all those who are in prison. And we remember organisations like the Bible Society that seeks to bring the word of God to those in prison. We pray for prison chaplains and prison visitors, Lord, and we pray that they may be able to share the gospel with those prisoners that they meet in the course of their work. And we pray that many prisoners would meet with you as they serve their sentence, Lord. May their meeting with you transform their lives, Lord, so that they can build a new and different life when they return into society. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And finally, we pray for refugees, homeless people, and for everyone we know who is sick or who needs a special touch from the Lord today. In a moment of quiet, let's just name to the Lord anyone we know who needs a blessing from the Lord today. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. Graciously hear us, Lord God. And the colic for today. O Lord, we beseech you mercifully to hear the prayers of your people who call upon you, and grant that they may both perceive and know what things they ought to do, and also may have grace and power faithfully to fulfil them. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. As our Saviour has taught us, so we pray together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. So, as usual, I'll just remind you that all the services for next Sunday are listed on the website or on the church news, if you get that by email. And there's, watch out for those other activities. There's quite a lot coming up. So there might just be something there that you would really like to do. So do read what's going on. You could even pray for it. And now our closing prayer. May the Lord bless us and preserve us from all evil and keep us in eternal life. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Thank you.